So if you have Netflix and do not know what to currently watch on it, this video will definitely help you. Hey guys, it's Angela, and in today's video, I'm sharing with you some Netflix binge-worthy TV shows. So if you have Netflix and do not know what to currently watch on it, this video will definitely help you. So before we get started, please subscribe if you're not already, and give this video a big thumbs up. Also, I do want to say sorry for not posting last week and the week before. I just kind of needed a little break. So let's get straight on with this video. As usual, I have the list on my phone, so I will kind of be peeking down at it every once in a while. So the first TV show I'm going to be sharing with you guys is probably one of my favorites, mainly because it reminds me of summer and just that nice warm time of the year. It is Outer Banks. So I'm going to be reading kind of the summary from Netflix because some of these I watched and some are on my wish list to watch. So sort of what this TV show is about, it's where this group of friends hunt for a legendary treasure linked to his father's disappearance, and there's like two groups on the island, Pogues and Kooks. It's super good, I would totally recommend it. And once again, if you love like summery movies, it totally reminds you of summer. It gives me like the most summer beachy vibes and I love it. The next one is Stranger Things. When I first started watching, I was like, I don't know if this is the type of TV show I like, but as I got into it, it's so good. So if you haven't watched it because you think it's like scary or something, trust me, it is not. And that's coming from me. So basically what it is, it's when a young boy vanishes, aka Will, a small town uncovers a mystery involving secret experiments, terrifying supernatural forces, and one strange little girl, also known as Eleven. So it's kind of this group of friends who are discovering this strange world called the Upside Down, and they kind of explore it, and there's like this monster dude, and it's super interesting. I'm not the best at explaining it, but go check it out, it's so good. The next TV show is called Lock and Key. This and Stranger Things are literally, I feel like, are so similar. Like, not the same concepts, but they have like the same kind of outline theme. This one's definitely creepier, so just a little heads up. After their dad's murder, three siblings move with their mom to his ancestral estate, where they discover magical keys that unlock powers and secrets. So basically, when their dad dies, they move into this secret mansion of his that they discover keys in, which lead to secrets, doors, and some other stuff. And I'm not gonna spoil it because I did see this one and it's so good. So that's all I'm gonna say, but it's so good. Totally like Stranger Things, they're so similar, and I would totally go check it out. The next one is definitely one of my favorites. It is Fuller House. This one's like so iconic, and if you haven't seen it, just go watch it. There is four seasons, I think, and they unfortunately just ended, and it's kind of sad, but if you saw Full House, it's like a spin-off to that, same characters. So I think it's super cool. It's just about this family and their life with DJ Fuller, Stephanie Fuller, and like all of them. Kimmy Gibbler. Can't forget her. So one of my favorites, it's so good. Next one, I'm gonna be straight up, it's like my favorite show. If you have TikTok, you may know. It's a kids show, but please, my sister like makes fun of me for it, but like it's so good. It's called Miraculous Tales of Ladybug and Cat Noir. Like, it seems like a kid's show, but seriously, it's so good. Please just watch it. Like, it's so interesting. They're coming out with a new season this year. It's the best. So basically, a little bit about this show is there's an evil villain called Hawk Moth. Basically, what he does is he akumatizes random people after they get, like, mad at something or something, or sad over something, or have an issue. And then Ladybug and Cat Noir, who are normal people, but with their miraculouses, they can transform into Ladybug and Cat Noir. They go and save the day, and it's so, so good. Please watch it. My favorite character is definitely Chloe.
Give, I made, I mean, out of the way. I wonder how many croissants your dad would have to sell to buy you one of these. What am I saying? He'd have to sell the whole store.
You know those like little mean girls and like sassy ones? It's, yeah, it's so good, just go watch it. The next show is The 100. I watched a few episodes, but I didn't really watch much more than that. So I'm gonna read a summary for you guys. Basically what it's about is 100 space station residents who I think, I'm pretty confident they were like prisoners, so they got sent down to Earth and they have to like survive on their own to see if everyone else is safe enough to come down. I'm not too good at explaining that one because I watched like two episodes, but those were so, the first two episodes were so good, and it's definitely a binge-worthy show, so definitely recommend this one. Also, I just think it's very ironic that every first episode on Netflix is called pilot. I'm pretty sure it just means it's like the tester first episode, but I'm so confused why they do that, but you know, it's okay. The next TV show series you can binge is Julie and the Phantoms. This is about when Julie lost her passion for music when she lost her mom. By the way, I did not watch this one yet, so I don't have too much knowledge on it, but this is what I want to watch. So Julie lost her passion for music when she lost her mom, but when three ghostly people appear and lift her spirits, they decide to start a band together. So it seems pretty good. I've seen a lot of people recommend this, so it's definitely on my wish list of wanting to watch on Netflix. Or, you get what I mean. Ooh, this next one is so good. It's a reality TV show. It is called The Circle. It is rated MA. By the way, most of these are TV-14, PG-14, but some of, like, Julie and the Phantoms was PG. So, this one's MA just because of the language. But it's basically about these people who, let me read it because I'm terrible at explaining things. So basically what The Circle is, it's where a bunch of players get their own room with like a social media, and they can either be a catfish or actually be who they are. So a catfish is basically where they pretend to be someone else and don't actually show who they are. But if they choose to just show themselves, they can do that. And no one knows if they're a catfish or not. So they can just like chat online with each other like through text. And then at the end, the last like few people can meet each other. And each round, someone else gets eliminated. And when they get eliminated, they have to show their true identity. And if they're a catfish, it's a real surprise. But if they're not, everyone's like, aw. So it's so good. It's really funny. The people in this are so funny, so I would totally recommend watching this show. By the way, Shuby's my favorite. So the next show is Umbrella Academy. I did not watch this one, but I will read you a summary from Netflix about what it's about. Once again, the ones I didn't watch are just kind of like on my watching wish list. And the reason they are on my wish list for watching is because a lot of people recommended that I binge them, or recommended them to me, so that's why. So this is about reunited by their father's death. Estranged siblings with extraordinary powers uncover shocking family secrets and a looming threat to humanity. So this seems super good. It seems like it has a little mysterious plot. And I watched the trailer and it's definitely one I want to watch. So, you know, it seems like another really good one to binge. Because you gotta binge. Summer's coming up, peeps. Gotta get those list of binge-worthy TV shows. The next one is Survivor. Survivor is so iconic and it's so good. So basically what Survivor is, it is where 20 people come to an island for about 40 days and they start off in two teams and they have to compete in challenges, and whichever team wins can get a little help for surviving. For example, like shelter, like a tarp, like some fish, etc. And the other team has to go to tribal council where one of the members gets voted off, and then later in the game all the teams merge and you have to win immunity for yourself at each challenge, and whoever wins immunity doesn't need to get voted off at night, but whoever doesn't win immunity has a chance of getting voted out, which means they could be going home. And it's overall so good to see who the real survivor is, and it's binge-worthy. My family and I finished like two seasons within a week, and it's so good, so I would totally recommend watching Survivor. The next TV show that is binge-worthy, and it's actually the final one, is Emily in Paris. So I haven't watched this one yet, but I've gotten so many recommendations from my friends, so I'm gonna be reading the summary off of Netflix. So after landing her dream job in Paris, Chicago marketing executive Emily Cooper embraces her adventurous new life while juggling work, friends, and romance. So this seems like a nice little drama adventure TV show, and it's rated MA. I'm pretty sure it's because of the language and like all that. So this is one I definitely want to watch. It seems binge-worthy, and I would totally recommend it. Also, one more thing on Netflix I would recommend. It is a movie. So it is called Enola Holmes with Millie Bobby Brown. If you know her, she's from Stranger Things. And it's so, so good. I watched it over the summer, last summer. Here, let me look it up for you. Okay, so I'm gonna read a little summary for you guys. So while searching for her missing mother, Enola Holmes uses her sleuthing skills to outsmart Big Brother Sherlock and help a runaway lord. So it's super good. I watched it and I would just totally recommend it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you've liked it. I hope you found some nice binge-worthy shows and even that one movie to watch, especially with summer coming up and a lot of downtime. You can just find some nice binge-worthy things to watch on Netflix. So if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe. It would mean a lot to me, and I will see you this upcoming Saturday. Bye!